Shah Waliullah. It is a part of key question 1. In this we will discuss how important were the religious reforms of Shah Waliullah. The religious reforms of Shah Waliullah and his role in the political and religious context of the time. Biography and beliefs. He was born on 21st February 1703. By birth he was given a name Qutubuddin. Waliullah was his title. He was greatly influenced by Abu Tahir. His father, Shah Abdul Rahim, was a religious scholar who helped in the foundation of Fatwa-e Alamgir under the direct supervision of Emperor Aurangzeb Alamgir. His father also founded Madrasa-e Rahimiya. Shah Waliullah taught at that madrasa for 12 years. In 1730, he went to Arabia for higher studies. Shah Waliullah believed that Islam has lost its glory in the subcontinent. He realized that it was necessary for Muslims to reconnect with Islam and its teaching if they want to improve their conditions. He wanted the rulers to enforce Islamic laws. He urged rich Muslims to live a simple life and traders to follow Islamic laws in their dealings. He feared that if reforms are not taken, then Muslims and non-Muslims will be indistinguishable. He despised the division of Shia and Sunni because it was weakening Muslim roots. Services in religion and politics. He completed the translation of the Quran in Persian, which was the local language at that time. He wrote a commentary on Ahadith in Persian and Arabic language. He arranged Ahadith with respect to their topics to make it easier for people to take guidance. He was a passionate author. Most of his writing is on fiqh and ahadith. He wrote 51 Islamic books, 28 in Persian and 23 in Arabic. His most recognized and famous book is Hujjatullah al-Baligha. In this book, he described the versatility and complete knowledge present in Islam and how it can guide people from all cultures and races. He studied writings available in various school of thoughts and then comprehensively explained in his writing what is really in Islam. Shah Waliullah, using his deep and political insight, tried to figure out the real cause of the Mughal Empire's decline. The Marathas was a great political power in the 18th century, were advancing to occupy the crown of Delhi. Keeping in view the looming threats, Waliullah wrote a letter to Ahmad Shah Abdali, who was the Afghan king, to help the Muslims of India in defeating the Marathas. He also prepared the Rohilla chief Najadullah and Nawab of Oud Shuja-ud-Dawlah for jihad. Ahmad Shah Abdali, also known as Ahmad Shah Durrani, defeated the Marathas in the Third Battle of Panipat. If you like this video, don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram and LinkedIn, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.